Hi, it's Jan at My Local Business Online, and today I want to go through fairly quickly some more settings on the Yoast WordPress SEO plugin. And today I want to talk about the metas and titles, and you can get to that section by clicking on the SEO tab in your dashboard and then titles and metas. This is quite a big section, so I'm not too sure how long this video will go on for. So first thing we're faced with is these tabs along the top and the general setting, title settings. The first one is force rewrite titles. Now what happens with WordPress, and it depends on the theme that you're running as well, is it will often duplicate your title. So if you post a link, say, onto Facebook, and you notice it says at the end, my fancy post / my website, it's duplicated the end bit of the title. It's because the theme isn't handling the SEO settings very well, and you can force a rewrite by ticking this box. For the most part, WordPress SEO will auto detect this setting, so you shouldn't have too much of a problem, but if that's what you're seeing, tick this box and it will sort it out. A little bit further down, we've got the site-wide meta settings. WordPress is a fantastic system, but it is a bit of a bugger for duplicate content, and duplicate content is a swear word online. You just can't. It's bad, you shouldn't do it. It's basically the same or very much the same content on your own website. And the bigger your website gets, and if you're blogging regularly, it's going to get pretty big pretty fast, then the more likely you are to be affected by duplicate content issues, and Google doesn't like it, and it'll come along with its panda algorithm and bite you. So to prevent the duplicating your content, you want to turn off some of the archiving. WordPress will, you'll think that you've written one post, and WordPress will actually publish it 4 or 5 or even 6 times, depending on the settings. So you'll write your post, it'll post it as a single post, it'll also post it in your author archives, your date archives, your category archives, your tag archives, and then you've got this bit here where it's got the page 1, page 2, page 3 of your archives. Well, if Google's already indexed your original post, you don't need the rest of the bump. So you want to noindex any sub-pages of your archives. The meta keyword tag, personal preference, it won't do any harm if you have it on there. It doesn't do any harm if you leave it off. The meta keyword tag has been devalued by the main search engines several years ago now. It's having a bit of a comeback at the moment with Google News, apparently. But it's, yeah, leave it on, turn it off. It's up to you. Personal choice. I don't use it, so I don't tick the meta keywords tag. The next sections that you want to look at is if your site basically gets put into demos or the Yahoo directory, those sites will generate their own description for your website, and these descriptions can show up in the search, and you don't want that to happen. Anything online, you want as much control as possible. So tick the box to say, no, I don't want these descriptions showing up, I want my own. A little bit further down is a complicated bit, is cleaning up your head section. And this is basically all the coding before it gets to the content of your site, all the coding in your head section that the search bots and the browsers see. You want as little as possible up there, so you get rid of all the bumps that you don't need. So one of these is the RSD and WLW links. These are used to auto post onto your blog, so actually removing them can tighten up your security a little as well. So if you're posting through a third party system or software, or if you're posting through your email or from your mobile, then you need to check which one of these that you need to keep and unhide it. But for most normal people who are using WordPress as a normal blog or as a website, you can hide these quite safely. You also don't need to show the short link for your posts either. One that you don't want to hide is your RSS links. RSS is a fabulous way of getting your content out there. Lots of tools use RSS to pull your content in, and yet it can be a bit frustrating when someone scraped your site through your RSS links. It's not a reason to turn it off. Please leave it on. And so don't hide that, and then click Save Settings. Next is the Home tab, and this is where you start to see all these percentages and shortcodes, and immediately sort of go, oh, that's far too much information, I don't know what that means, and switch off. Don't be overwhelmed. The home page is your first page, and if you're running your site as a blog, this title and description will change depending on what your last blog post was, and it's not always what you want to show up in the search engines to represent you and your business. So change your site template to what you want to be shown in the search engines. These shortcodes, there's a huge list of them in the help section here, so don't be overwhelmed, you can use any of these, and there's a description next to them about which one that you want to do. Personally, I use the site name and then the separator and the site description. The site name and the site description are what you set in the WordPress settings, in the general settings, which is this bit here, site title, site tagline. This is in your general settings on the left hand side, settings, and then general. So your site title and your site tagline. And that's what these are. Site name, site description is your title and your tagline. And if you've used your keywords and your location in those descriptions, then this will be more than enough. Write your meta description here. This should be something that appeals to people and they want to click through to visit your site. Don't leave this one blank, so put something compelling there. A little bit further down, not too sure why this isn't in the social section, but author metadata is referring to Google Plus. You can connect your website to your Google Plus profile and your Google Plus local business page. And this is where you do the first part of it. This puts a bit of code into the header of the website. So even if you haven't got Google Plus buttons on your site and the follow me, circle me bit, Google will still recognise your rel equals author and rel equals publisher. It knows your website belongs to you. So first of all, you want to choose which author you want to show. If you're running a single author blog, that's fine. If you're not, use the main author, the person that's going to be posting the most. And if it's your business, preferably someone posting as you. You do need to add the Google Plus profile to the user profile. So you want to pop over here and add your Google Plus data into this section here. This is the author profile. It's under users, your profile. The next part down here is your Google Plus page for your business. This will be your Google Plus local about page. Copy and paste it into here, and this will put the tag rel equals publisher into the header of your website. Now, I've not noticed this making a huge difference in the search results yet, not as much as the author, rel equals author, which puts your image into the search results for certain search terms. I have noticed this works wonderfully well with people who use their own photograph. It doesn't work so well for me who uses a logo instead of a profile picture, but then Google does say that it wants faces up there, and that's what it puts in there. So save your settings once you've changed everything over. The next tab is post types, and once again you'll see these percentages. Don't be overwhelmed, you have a few more options here as well. So I take out, personally I go for title and site name. And what happens here is, I'm going to write a post, and I put my fancy title here. And I write my blog post. Really exciting stuff. When you scroll down and you've got your Yoast set up, you'll see your settings below here. And your SEO title, when you click Generate SEO Title, what it does is it pulls the title that you've used at the top of the page and then puts your site name after it. And that's because it's defined here, title, separator, site name. What you don't particularly want to do is put in a meta description template. Your titles and your description should be unique for every post and every page that's on your website. So you can define it under here, sit and type, and write that. And what I've found working with my clients is when I've defined a meta description, they don't overwrite it, they don't change it down here. So I would advise leave it blank, don't get lazy, write a new meta description each time you post. You don't want to noindex any of your posts and your pages on a global scale. Obviously, if you want to do that on an individual level, you can do that as part of the Yoast settings under advanced with the nofollow. Don't do it on a global scale as part of these settings. You can choose whether you want to have the date in the snippet. It's off by default. And that's the same for posts and pages and media. You may have other pages and posts like this one down here. Depends on the theme that you use, and if you've got special pages, special posts, that they'll be down here and you can set them exactly the same way as you do with your posts and your pages. The next one along, we go delve even deeper in now, and this is where you start no indexing things and thinking about what you want the search engines to see. How you set up your blog and whether you use categories or tags for navigational purposes will define whether you no index your categories and or your tags. I personally prefer to no index tags and leave your categories indexed. It does depend on how you use your website though. I wouldn't personally have both of them left indexed. There can be quite a lot of crossover, and that's when you're going to run into the problems again of duplicate content. So unless you're very, very blinkered and never use the same tags as your categories, which you shouldn't be doing anyway, but either index one and not the other. I prefer to index categories and no index tags. Again, what the title is can be defined by short codes, or you can wipe the whole lot off and type whatever you want in here as well. But I recommend that you use your keywords. And again, depending on the theme that you've got in, you may have additional sections as well. Finally, there's the other one. And this is where you want to no index your author archives, particularly if you're a single author blog. You've got the option to totally disable your author archives, and the reason why I don't do that is very much a user experience. I actually had someone ask me about it. They clicked on my name in the post, see more posts by Jan, and went back to the home page, which is what happens when you disable the author archives, and it was confusing. So that doesn't leave a good user experience. So personally, I no index the author archives because they're exactly the same as all the other blog archives, because most of the time there's only me blogging. But you may choose to disable the author archives. There is a very good reason to disable them. They're not generally needed. I would also disable the date-based archives as well. They're not required. You've got your categories and you've got your tags. Unless you're navigating on your website by date archives, there's no reason to have them there. There's definitely no reason to index them all. Because that's when you fall into the trap of duplicate content. Now, your special pages, your search pages and your 404 pages are no index by default. You may want to choose your wording here, again, using the short codes, or you can take them off totally and type in whatever you want to do there as well. So that's about it. I know it's quite a big section and I've rushed through it. So if you've got any questions, please do ask. I think the main thing to realise is don't let the short codes overwhelm you. They're all listed in the help file, make sure that your title has your keyword in there. If you're running it as a local business, make sure your titles have your location in there where they're relevant as well, definitely on your pages, if not always on your blog posts. And that's about it, so I'll speak to you soon.